Hi, my name's Jade Kay. I'm a makeup artist in Melbourne. I'm lucky enough to do what I love daily with amazing talent. So I've received so many emails, so many messages asking me to start a video or a YouTube channel, which I have
so
finally done.
Have.
It's a series I'm going to do called In the Makeup Chair with Jade Kay. I work with amazing people. I'm so lucky. So every month, few weeks, I'm going to do In the Chair with Jade Kay. We're going to focus on what that signature look we do with clients like Nadia Bartel, who we have here today.
Thank
Thanks for being my first
I
personality.
Know,
so excited.
We love this look. We love a really glam look. I love a lot of makeup. Love glamming it up, particularly in the eyes. So I love what you created today. And I learned so much as well.
I hope you did. Well, that's the thing that we're going to be creating, every signature look to that client. So today, Nadia is so well known for her glam nighttime look. That's what we've gone for. So hopefully if you want to see a breakdown of products, other things that you'd like to see in future videos, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and keep watching. Thank you. Bye. So Nadia, I know that you prefer a more matte finish. So what we've done today is we've prepped the skin prior and we're gonna go into an amazing eye, smoky eye that Nadia is known for that every client I ever get asks for because it looks so amazing. She's got the perfect shape. So we've prepped the skin earlier. We've used our foundations and primers, which I'll go through. But you typically, Nadia, you prefer a matte finish, yeah?
Love a matte finish with my makeup and my eyes because I have super oily skin. Jay's done an amazing job of making me look flawless, but I did not look like this.
She does have perfect skin, so this is a good start. Do you like the matte finish normally the way it's photographed, or what's your main reason?
Well, I just find that you know me so well. Like when you do my makeup, I want it to last all day, and sometimes when it's a little bit more dewy, it just seems to come off easier. So I just want it to be like matte, looks amazing in photos, and just lasts the whole night.
Yeah, so it doesn't slide off. So a lot of clients, whether it be your everyday or it's to last you through work, to drinks, the foundations and primers, which I'm obsessed with at the moment, and I know you are too, Nards, is the BECCA one. So what we used earlier was the Velvet Blurring Primer. So I just applied it mainly to Nadia's forehead because it does get quite oily there, the European in her.
Very.
So, like myself, so which is great because you don't age as badly. So now that we have this amazing matte finish with a nice bronzed look already, we will leave the contouring to the end and we'll start with the eyes. So what I typically do is I don't use all these fancy, I'm quite old school when it comes to the eyes, I just use a really good, reliable concealer and set it with powder. Once again, I'm just gonna go with the NARS. So if you just look down, Nadia, you just apply a little bit to the center of the lids. That's okay. That on top. We've got kind of a neutral, nice base now. We can go straight into applying the shadow. So I love a lot of shadows at the moment that are really great warm orange base, which I know you love.
Love. Earthy tones.
Earthy tones. Or matte. I actually pulled out these MAC little orange shadows. They're my go-to. Even if you have a brown, quite cool brown color, you can add these to it and it warms them up. Even on top or with it. One of them's so old that you can't, it's actually called red. So when she saw
these. She pulled them out and she was like, we're gonna do this eye. And I'm like, no way is that orange colour going in my lips. When it's this colour like that, you think it's like orange.
Yeah.
But obviously then when Jade applied it, it was like the most amazing eye makeup ever. And it suits a lot of different eye colours as well, doesn't it?
It does.
I couldn't believe it. You totally swayed me. And then now I've
she's obsessed with it.
I own
only orange. What I'm doing now is I'm actually applying that orange, which is the Rule by MAC, mixed in with Summer Yum from the Too Faced Peach Palette. So I'm just gonna buff them into the eye. I would never have expected feeling so connected. It must have been our destiny. And now I know I'll never let this ever, ever end in somewhere other than next to me. Wing this right out and emphasize that. And where Nadia's eyebrow is, if you just look this way, we're gonna bring it way out that way and perfect it at the end. So the shades we're gonna use now are gonna be a little bit darker. And this one is Fudge by Anastasia Beverley Hill. Mm. Yep. It actually feels like velvet. We're going to continue using these two palettes for this smoky eye. The good thing about the peach palette is it's got a lot of warm tones, but it does have also Charmed, I'm sure, at the top here, which is great when creating that little bit more sexier, if you you can see that there. It's a cooler brown, so we're going to be using that too. Across the whole lash, right near the lash line, I've smudged in the fudge, and now we're going to go back in, mixing basically these three shades to create a deeper, sexier, smoky eye look. So bear with me, and I'll create that now. So these are my three brushes that I swear by. One's the number 18 Wayne Goss, the number 20, and the 217 MAC. So if you're gonna create any perfect smoky eye. I mean, especially for myself, with most people when they bring your photos, is we go quite heavy underneath.
Yeah.
So that's where you really go in there. I actually use not always the best brushes. I use actually a Wayne Goss number 18, and then I fluff it out with the 217 underneath the eye as well. So we might grab that lighter shade. You can always build it up, mix it in.
Just pop these two. I love the look of so much color under there. So many people don't like it, do they?
Well, they say they don't. And then once you actually do it.
Because it doesn't close the eye, it actually opens it.
It makes it look bigger.
Yeah.
And you just have to have the belief, this is a process. It doesn't happen straight away. It's about building it up. I just build it up. So you keep adding, keep adding. It's always good to start lighter, but also be a bit heavy-handed with underneath the eye, because people are, I think, they're quite, oh, sorry, we just had a little bit fall there. We'll fix up underneath the eye once we finish. But people can be a little bit heavy-handed on the top, yet at the bottom of the eye or underneath the eye, they're very, they put the tiniest bit of eyeliner, or they put nothing. And I always say, it reminds me of being top heavy.
Yeah.
All boobs and no bum. You gotta have it balanced. Pre-fall before, which happens all the time when you're doing a smoky eye. That's why sometimes it's good to do the foundation last. If you just use trusty, I call these erasers, the cotton buds, and just kind of, when you're applying it, just kind of flick it like that and just blend it, and it'll normally it'll either go way worse, so just keep going and be patient, because I know so many people get impatient. And the other thing is to use a concealer and just kind of fix that up and always go back in. I'm just showing you now how to do that, but I would normally wait to the very end and fix it and just buff that in and kind of. But most people have this Desert Dusk palette by HUDA.
I do, but I don't know how to use it.
Yeah, and they're so amazing.
It's hard to know which colours to use.
The good one when you're blending is to use the musk with your 217 also. And just, if you kind of blend it in, it kind of makes that sultry. I'm also going to mix that Charmed, I'm sure, again, in with the fudge and pop it across the lash line. And then I'm going to go over it with an eyeliner. So if you go across, again, the lash line, and it doesn't need to be neat. Kind of done the mainly shadow. I can go back at the end. We've elongated it out. We could always add a little bit more depending kind of the final look. But they're all the shadows we've used, so I'll give you a break of those nods. I really love Teddy, which is a classic by MAC, but the Mecca's own Mecca Maxima's
it's really good.
Brown this, yeah. Eyeliner, I love. It's just the perfect colour. So it's still deep and cool. It's not too warm. But then I do love Teddy too, because it's got that little bit of sparkle to it. Only a little bit. So when you've done a complete matte, it's good too with blending. So smudge it over that darker lash. I just really with a smoky eye, I think where NARS we get along and you like it with kind of all the makeup artists you use, is it's not so neat.
Yeah, I don't like when it's got to be so perfect.
It's just kind of have fun with it. Be a bit, I think a lot of people with makeup, they tend to do it so neat, so blended. Have fun, smudge it a bit. The eye is really important. That's for me where you get the whole look.
That's hard for me to master. I can never blend it properly.
Well, it's really important as well, because it shapes your whole eye. So it's really important too, like with creating that kind of angle without doing all that, without doing an actual liquid liner. And the best way to do it is apply like we just did and blend it out. So, and just look forward, Nads. So we just get that kind of sexy Smokey, and I'll go back and perfect it with any concealer at the very end. So now we're going to get into the lashes. Now lashes are so important with shaping your eyes, especially when you're doing this kind of nighttime look. I think mascara is really important in what you do with your lashes. It's really important to clean them at night, to take off all excess mascara, because that's when you get the most damage, nighttime when it's all sitting there and your eyes are shut. So Benefit, They're Real is my current fave. I love the brush as well. It's kind of, you look at it, you don't think it's gonna be, it's great for the bottom lashes as well. Nadia's got quite long bottom lashes. So what I'll do before I curl the top, I'm just gonna apply that to the bottom. So we just look up. So now as a makeup artist, one of our hardest things to do is when you're curling someone else's lashes. I tend to use the Shiseido or the SHU UMERA on eyes that are more kind of outward rather than kind of a bit flatter. I use the SHU UMERA. And it's always the best way to open up. Everyone should do it. You know, I've had everyone ask me things like, I do it in three sections, middle, right near the lash line, middle, and then right at the end.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, so you tend to, you can't just do one or two, you need to do like three. So you go right in, and with the lash, you have to really apply it to the lash line quite heavy, and then just lightly brush it through to the tips, because I hate it sitting on the tips. So always apply it right near your lid lash line, and then like I said, just lightly brush it through. The next bit is applying the lashes. So I know Nadia, you do love your Model Rock. Model Rock are great. Yeah, they are good. Sometimes it's hard because I run out so fast. I trained in England with Ardell, so I love the Ardell ones, but those two are my go-to products. So the ones we're using today are the 117 strips. Another one that, you know, tends to suit most people is a demi lash.
I hear so much about the demi.
Yeah, they just tend to suit everyone.
Is demi smaller?
They are smaller. These, because we're doing a nighttime kind of evening look, I've gone for the 117s, and they're quite, you know, they elongate as well, so they start off quite small and then go out. So we're just going to, what I tend to do when you're applying lash, now this is the hardest part, if you pick it by, pick it up by the lashes after you put it off, grab a tweezer, now let the glue, I'm using Duo glue, if you just kind of wave it a bit because it sets, then apply it with the back of the tweezers, just like that, evenly, because this is really important. If the lash doesn't go on properly and it's not applied with the right amount of glue, then you're going all day, you've got one flipping about. So once you've done that, once again, wave it. You've got to get the exact kind of tackiness so it'll stick. And then if you just look down, and even if you're in the mirror and you're trying to apply it, you have to, it's the way you go in. So kind of hold it with two like that. Go in right at the center. And you can move it about. And you know, they are long, but
they feel good, yeah.
They feel light. Mm. Make sure that when you're putting a lash on also, just make sure that the end just sits perfectly. It's how it sits on the end when we're doing that elongated look. So applied it like that, and now I'll pop on the other one so we have matching eyes. Quickly blend it all. As you can tell, if you look that way, Nadia, it's quite angled, and I have, you know, blended it, but it's still got quite an angle on there. So you can do, depending on what look you're looking for, you can blend in even more. And then at the very end, what I do, remember back in the days when it was so like the highlighter,
yes,
here on the nose, that's kind of moved on now. We're onto the matte skin, matte eyes. We're not doing as much. I mean, if you looked at the red carpet lately in Hollywood, people aren't going as crazy with the highlight, with the contour. It's more just that fresh skin and not so angular.
Yes, like an all over glow.
Yeah.
Instead of it being like this is where you apply just dark contour.
Just moisturised really. So what I do now is I just use the WhatsApp by Benefit. Just grab a little brush that you can get right into the corners. This is a highlighter that's obviously designed for your face. But then I just pop it in here and just gives you a nice kind of creamy. I don't use powder highlighters hardly ever anymore. It's just always a cream. And then if you just look that the other way, babe, it just gives you enough highlighter that it makes you awake, but it's not so in your face kind of pigmented.
Yes.
you know, and you can just press it in with your fingers.
Goes on well.
Yep.
Just doesn't go cakey, like it's just beautiful.
And now I'm just going to apply this little bit of it wherever I want. So good because it just picks up where the light hits you in the camera, not so sitting on your face, it melts in. BECCA obviously do a great one, and Charlotte Tilbury, I'm just looking this way to the other side. If you are going to use one, Charlotte Tilbury's powder, you know, the highlighting duo, that is good too. The Aura Gloss by Victoria Beckham for Estee Lauder. So if you wanted a glossy eye, this is your product, but it's for the upkeep, it's sometimes a bit hard. So I just tend to like, just really lightly pop a little bit there, just with that finger. And that's the healthy, that's like what everyone wants, just a bit of glow, not overload, dumped powder on your face. So, and don't get me wrong, I've walked out sometimes and actually done that. Luma, which is a great brand I love, by Heart Girls, is this is good too because this is a cream and this can be used as in the inner eye on your lip. It's just perfect consistency as well. It's not as clear gloss. It's got a little bit of a tint to it.
A little bit more.
Yeah, but I've always, and it's affordable. You can buy it from Priceline. You should be able to for $24, $25.
That's
so this
good.
One's for Nadia's kind of color tone. You're looking at Golden Glow. That's for just the medium bronzed look. So now we'll get straight to the contouring.
Anyone?
Do you know what? When I first met Nadia, she would literally be like, I can't do makeup, but she was so fussy about her makeup, but she can't do it. But now she is, she doesn't really need us.
No, I do need
She really doesn't.
I definitely do.
So what I tend to use on my clients, you can actually buy these, is they're the cream Bobbi Brown. This is like the perfect palette, and I'm lucky enough
to
have this.
Many.
There's so many.
I
so
need
much
that.
Is, so it's a cream. I tend to like to contour with creams, and I think you've all seen. I love the Real Techniques brush, which is English, by the Pixie Lock Girls. So these, I just think it just blends. It does the job for you. So if you kind of find the hollowness in your cheek, just here, it's kind of rather than just doing a line, you can hug the cheek. So that's it. Depends which way you want to go about it. So if you want to kind of press, you can hug the cheek like this. This might be easier for some people, or other people, they tend to love the blending. So you just gotta find as well your own technique. You know what I mean? It's not, and that's just with a little tiny bit, you can already see it changes the dimensions. So the shade that I've used is the Almond and Walnut, and all you need to buy, if I was to say to purchase this yourself, buy two shades, a lighter shade and then your dark contouring shade, and you can use that and it will last you. And if it is that you want to use it as a foundation later, you can, but I just find the creams all melt into each other. So, you know, it's just a lot easier than using a powder. So I'm just going to continue to kind of build that up. So around the halo of the head, just like this, and I just like to press it in. Like that. And then around the cheekbone underneath there, around the jaw, but you kind of just dust it. You don't want to have a totally different color to your neck. Just bronze it in. It's really important, don't be scared as well to just really apply the foundation all the way down the neck, because most people, if you're looking after your skin, get absolutely no sun in that area. The other part that I think Nadia, you probably remember about me, is I have a thing with ears.
Yes.
Do not leave your ears, especially with spray tans and things, go right in the ear, whether it be with your foundation or whatever it is, just get rid of the colour that is not matching your face and the rest of your body, because most of
you
us...
You don't want white ears.
No, you definitely don't.
Natural,
even though I do love, like this kind of makeup I love, because this is how I do it myself. But I think it's about the energy, the whole thing. I mean, Nards, you have, I obviously love you.
Yeah,
you know, I do a lot of work with Rachel Finch, and she loves a natural
she
look.
She does love a natural look. She's
and
like
it kind of, she
beautiful.
Pushes, yeah, she yeah. pushes me probably, because I always want to add more, but she does, she really understands her face and she trusts me, and I think that's what it is with beauty. You have to trust if someone's doing your face, and you have to trust that they understand the shape of your
face.
I'm going to go in and just contour quite lightly Nadia's nose.
Yes, I love this. Please keep
so,
contouring.
This is kind of good if you, sometimes if you want to just,
so
at home.
So what brush are you using? I need to copy.
This is a Real Techniques brush as well. And it's just really lightly, this is with a
It's a bit fluffy.
Yeah, I like it to be, but it's still precision, so you can go in there. And then if you get the other side, like that.
Are you using
you've got to blend it in, cream. Yep. Sorry, and you kind of get it right back into the bush of the brow and come down, like don't be scared. Tip, sorry, it's hard to, I've got to keep moving around. But at home, it can be hard to contour your nose. I will be honest with you. This is the part that you can really go wrong. Because I kind of do it on the bridge there, but then you've got to go right down, back in, and be able to also blend it. So it's ever so, it's better to start off quite natural rather than...
Less is more on the nose, isn't it?
Yep. But and you have to kind of take a step back sometimes. So I've done that side, but I need a little bit more in the other. Sorry if my arm's in the way. And then pop there. Whatever you do, this highlighting is bringing forward, contouring is bringing back. So when you're adding this, I'm bringing this part of the nose forward to your sight. So anyone that puts highlighter on here is asking for the tip of their nose to be brought forward.
I do see that when people do that.
So you don't want to do that. So I always apply it and then you stop it where you want it to stop. And you just kind of, with the kind of the bronzer and then just tap it. Okay, so now we're going to go in, like you said, and set it lightly with some powder. So the Anastasia Contour Kit Medium Tone, this actually is my go-to for Nadia's whole eyes and contour, and you can use it at home, but today we haven't. If you just go in with the shade kind of here and mix it, because it's warm and cool, so I often do that, and just grab the BECCA fan brush and kind of just lightly, almost, just feather-like.
Was walking by the ocean, feeling all emotion.
When she came right up next to me, I got caught up in the... Eyebrows is actually where I started in England, so I'm really fussy with eyebrows. It's my
you do an amazing
it's kind
brow.
Of my pet hate, like when you have, thank you babe, but when you have such a good eye and the brow just doesn't do it justice. So Nadia's really lucky, she's got a great shape, so it's about brushing them up. Nadia's eyebrows are already perfect and I have overplucked thin brows. There's a lot of ways you can go about it, but the two products that I tend to go with is the BENNEFIT Precisely My Brow Pencil. They have nailed the colours. They're lighter, so it's always important to go lighter than your brow. I've gone for a shade 2 or 3 in the BENNEFIT, and that suits, it's quite universal, it suits everyone, you can just build it up. And I've also got the L'Oreal, which can be purchased at any kind of drugstore or Priceline, is the Brow Artist Plum Pass. So this one I love, I don't even know if I have the colour, but you can get them in all different shades. Just kind of mascara it through, and it sets the brow. So before you start, you've got a bit of colour, and you've also got that makes them quite fluffy. And now as well, it's not as that kind of chiseled look. It's more quite, not as angular. It's a bit more round, yet still shaped. I'm just gonna finish that. Just pop a bit of concealer where it's good to have a few little flyaway hairs, but I think at the top, it's nice to be quite clean. So just once again, I haven't used a lot of products today. I've just kind of kept it quite simple. And then we're just going to buff that in. So that it's just nice and clean. And then we're going to get to the lips. The lips for me, I am a real believer in liner. I don't care how much. It's obviously, I have a few liners that are my go-to, and I think the company that has absolutely nailed liners this last 2017, 2018, I saw the new stuff that's coming out at Sephora yesterday's showcase,
yes,
is Kat Von D. Like, she has, whether it's eyeliners, whether it's lip liners, she's just nailed it. They stay on.
Can't wait to see
They're really, really good. So this one here.
That's a nice colour.
It's a nice colour. It's also close to the Strip Down by MAC, and that's another... one I love. So them two are probably my favourite at the moment. The Kat Von D, this one is Bow and Arrow. So I tend to actually mix them. They're a little bit more moisturising than the MAC one. So if you put your lips together and you tend to just just goes on and it applies so easy. This is a little bit lighter. So I just like a crayon, literally, just goes on the lips. And over the top of that, apply, obviously your fave, Ilia in These Days.
It is. From BECCA. It's
easy.
Amazing.
It sells out though. This one's These Days. And because I've gone for a darker kind of liner, if we just apply it like this, it's natural. It's one of the very few natural makeups as well. It's not got any added parabens or nasty. So I really, really like this one. So that one's done. Lips for me are really important. I hate it looking too lipsticky, so I almost go in there and pat it out. And then I also get a tiny bit of the Benefit, just for a bit of dimension, and pop it in the middle. So for me now, I mean, the only areas you probably need to powder are your forehead, because I can tell it still does get a bit oily. But the products that I really like for powder is the Laura Mercier powder. I love the BECCA one. Sorry, today I've gone pretty hard on BECCA, but I am obsessed with it at the moment. You know, the other thing with the BECCA highlighter, which I have to explain to everyone because I learnt this at an information evening with BECCA a few months ago, is Champagne Pop, all their shimmering pressed, yeah, that's their go-to. The reason why their highlighters are so good is because they do a cream and then a powder. So the way this is pressed, you know, a lot of highlighters are just powders. They actually do cream, then another layer of powder, then cream and another layer of powder.
Is it too cakey that the powders aren't like a usual powder?
No. So this BECCA product, yeah, this is a highlighter, but also their powders, the packaging, everything is perfect.
That's a beautiful colour.
Yeah, so you can always dust that a little bit if you want. I'm just using my fingers, but you can dust that a little bit around here. This brush kind of just perfects it, but that's pretty much it. That is the nighttime look. So now we have finished the nighttime, my first video.
Yes.
Yay, with NARS.
So much fun.
It was fun. And
thanks for having me.
Thank you for coming to my house as well. We filmed here. So we finished the nighttime signature look that Nadia kind of tends to wear out, and she looks amazing in. It's most requested by all our clients, my clients. And as you can see, we used the matte foundation, the deep eye, and we warmed it up with the more orange tones, soft contour, and the lighter nude lip. So I'll have all the brands and products that we used attached so that you can go and recreate this look.
I can't wait to watch it.
Yeah.
Create it myself.
Yeah, you'll be able to do it.
I know.
Thank you, and keep the comments coming. Let me know what other things you'd like to see moving forward. But I've had a really good time and can't wait to do more.
Thank you.